In her, he met his own eternity. This is the description of the divine Savitri, poised to take the mortal birth. She'll come here and accept the lot of humanity, the lot of suffering humanity. She will bear on her shoulder the yoke of ignorance and death. She will take mortal birth to remove the stigma of death on the soul of humanity, on the soul of man, on the soul of the earth. Even while the divine Savitri comes here as human Savitri, takes the mortal birth, even in that state of humanity, she, in her aspects of humanity, still remains the same divine. The divine elements are always present in her. They do not depart from her. She comes with those divine elements and they always remain with her, although she has taken the mortal birth, although she has put on her soul the thick robe, the thick veil of humanity, of mortality. With those divine elements of love, beauty, joy, strength, sweetness, all those beautiful things, she is still human. And therefore, she becomes in that human state with all those divine elements present in her, a perfect shrine, a shrine of perfection, where the God of love can dwell happily. She becomes a perfection shrine for the God of love to dwell in it. That is the divine aspect present always, even in human Savitri. Always in her, whatever is there in her, all in her points to a nobler kind. Her flame of divinity, even from this lower level, climbs up to the greatest skies, to the highest sky. All in her is pointed to a nobler kind. Her large vision spirit can soar in the utmost sky, can soar in the sky where things have yet to take birth. Unborn things soars to the unborn things. Her mind, it is a sea of white sincerity. Her life, a passionate flow of the sea. Her will, firm and unstumbling. Hers is a heart of silence in the hands of joy. And her body is a parable of dawn. Such is the description all the physical aspects of the divine Savitri who has taken the human birth. Her mind, a sea of white sincerity, her will, firm and unstrumbling, her heart of silence in the hands of joy, her body a parable of dawn, and her movements in time always are the movements of immortal rhythms. Even in time's process, it is the rhythm of the immortal which moves in that time, and her act is always a wide self-giving for the earthly creature. That is a native act. Wide self-giving was her native act. Her high passion, that is the heaven's equipoise, a deep of compassion, her inward help opens out the gates of heaven. Her help, it is that power, it throws the gates of heaven open for the aspiring soul of man. That is the help one gets always from Savitri. And such wide is her heart that the whole world could take refuge in it. A whole world could take refuge in her single heart. Love in her is wider than the universe. The universe is living, moving, growing in her love. Love in her wider than the universe. And when she has taken the mortal birth, it is the unsatisfied god of love who could still dwell in it and be happy in it. What is spiritual would become divine, would become divine with her touch. Ocean of untrembling virgin fire, that is what she is. She is an ocean of untrembling virgin fire, and she is a continent of self-diffusing peace and strength of silence. Silence, the gods, is always with her. In her, that God of love, found a vastness like his own, the way in which he would move in his native place. That vastness, he found that vastness in her. In her, he met his own eternity.